All right, this is going to be a Goliath of a video. So be sure to bookmark it, come back, take a couple breaks, be sure to digest everything because there's going to be a lot of information here that you're gonna have to unpack. Plus it's gonna be a little bit easier because I've timestamped everything for you in the video. Now real quick before we get into the video, a quick word from today's sponsor.
VIP SCD Keys is an online digital retailer who offers digital product keys at affordable prices. They offer keys for Windows products as well as Steam keys, Origin keys, Uplay keys, PC games keys, and even Xbox and PSN card keys. Now we all know that when you're building a PC, the one thing we never want to pay for is the Windows activation key, right? A Windows 10 Pro key from Microsoft costs $200, but from SCD Keys, it only costs $20. All you have to do is type in hashtag VIPSK in the search bar and it'll bring you right to your own copy of Windows 10 Pro. And the best part is if you use code PP20 at checkout, you'll get an additional 20% off your purchase, making it just $16. Now, not only do they have Windows 10 Pro keys, but they also have Microsoft Office Pro keys that you can use my code on to bring your purchase down from $58 to $47. And the best part is both products can be bought safely and securely through multiple different payment methods. Once you've completed your purchase, just let it redirect you to the order status page. Click the View Keys and Codes button, then click the Get the key button. Next, open your Windows start bar and type in about and press enter. At the bottom, click on change product key, then click on change product key again. A little box will pop up. Go ahead and paste your key in there and then wait for Windows to activate. So be sure to check out the link in the description down below to get your keys today.
All right, so in my last video, I taught you how to make a webcam look like a DSLR, but openly stated that you can never actually get a webcam to replace a DSLR just because of the lack of manual controls. But maybe you're finally ready to make that jump into a professional quality camera like a DSLR, but you don't really know where to start. Well, that's where I come in. If there was one thing that I wish I had when I started YouTube and Twitch streaming, was a channel that I could confide in to figure out all of the steps I needed to take in the content creation process. I want to be this person for other upcoming YouTubers and Twitch streamers because I know how frustrating it is to try to sift through hours of research and then still be unsure about the decisions that you want to make when it comes to buying gear or what you should do for your settings. I want to be that guy where you can come to my videos and go, okay, this is right, this is the way I should do it, and this is how I'm going to do it. I want to make this as easy and simple as possible for any upcoming YouTubers or Twitch streamers, and in turn, you guys will share it with your friends, not because it gets me more views, but because I understand how frustrating it can be. I want someone that you guys can confide in, and I want you to be able to do what you do best, which is making content. All right, so today's video is going to cover 5 key points to help you pick the right camera for your setup. Now, if you haven't already, don't forget to jump into the Discord because I'm going to have a nice little summarized guide for you in the free stuff section of the Discord. Also, let me make something really clear. I'm not going to show you how to set up the camera in this video. There's already going to be too much information and that's just going to be an absolute overload. So today's video is just going to be how to pick out the body, the lens, and all the accessories you need for the camera of your choice. And then I'm going to be doing another video how to actually set up the camera properly. So first we're gonna start with the accessories. There's 3 accessories you're gonna need. The first being the capture card. The most common is the Elgato Camlink. Now the Camlink that Elgato sells right now goes up to 4K 30 or 1080p 60. The card typically runs about $130 US and it's literally just plug it in and it works. You should download the Elgato Capture software just to make sure it's up to date with the most recent software. But after you've done that, once you plug it in, literally just add it into OBS and it works. It's right there. There are cheaper capture card alternatives, but I don't suggest getting one of those just because you're gonna be spending a decent chunk of change on the camera and the lens. So you wouldn't wanna bottleneck the quality of your camera by getting a $30 capture card off Amazon. You can if you can't afford the Camlink, and then as you make more money, upgrade to the Camlink. But I suggest if you can swing it, getting the Camlink just to get right out of the gate with the best quality possible. Number 2, you're gonna either need a micro or mini HDMI depending on the camera that you want. Now most cameras nowadays come with these in the box, but they're pretty short. They're usually 3 to 4 feet, maybe 6 feet if you're lucky. So you can either get a female to male HDMI adapter to extend it like a 6-foot or 8-foot cable. But what I did is I got a USB 3.0 10-foot extension cable to move the Camlink closer to the camera. So that way, if I ever decide to move away from using the Camlink for some reason, that I still have an extension USB cable that's dedicated to using any product rather than a specific HDMI cable that can only be used with other HDMI cables. And the third thing you're gonna need is a dummy battery. This looks like basically a battery that plugs into the camera But what it does is it actually plugs into the wall to give you continuous power to the camera. It's gonna look basically like a laptop charger, but with a little battery that replaces the one that comes with your camera, and it just pops in, and then your camera will be able to run continuously and you won't have to worry about the battery draining and running out. So those were the easy three accessories that you need no matter what camera you get. Now here's the first big one, the body of the camera. So cameras are broken into three parts: the body, the lens, and the sensor. And there are a plethora of bodies to choose from, and there's two styles. There are DSLRs, like what I'm shooting on right now, which is a Canon 80D, and there are mirrorless cameras like a Sony A6000. The difference between the two is that the Canon 80D has a physical mirror to reflect the image that the lens is seeing onto the sensor, versus a mirrorless camera, which just takes the actual image itself and puts it directly onto the sensor. Now, in terms of performance and functionality wise, you're not going to see a difference between the two for streaming. You do, however, need to know if your body has a mirror in it just for lens compatibility's sake, because some bodies that are mirrorless are not compatible with certain lenses because they were built for bodies with mirrors. Now, the biggest difference you're going to notice between mirrorless cameras and mirrored cameras is the body size of them. DSLRs typically tend to be more traditional style, the larger, more hand-gripped ones, while mirrorless cameras like the Sony A6000 typically tend to be more compact and streamlined. And really, this just comes down to preference and what's gonna fit with your setup. The sensor, you don't need to know too much about for this sake, but there are two types. There are full frame and there is a crop sensor. Full frame sensors are basically set to the industry standard of recording or shooting at 35 millimeters, while crop sensors are set to a smaller size, effectively letting you see less than what a full frame sensor would see. The only reason you need to know about sensor size is for lens compatibility. If you're getting a full frame sensor versus a crop frame sensor, whatever lens you choose to pick, you need to make sure that not only is it compatible with the body, but it's also compatible with the sensor. Now, don't stress too much about that, because most manufacturers, when you are picking the lens, will tell you what is compatible with what body. Next, you're gonna have to pick what resolution you wanna broadcast at. I have a Canon 80D and its highest resolution is 1080p 60. For me, that's perfectly fine. You can get cameras that do 4K and the Cam Link does technically support 4K 30, but there are no streams that support 4K 30 right now. So realistically, all you would be doing is future-proofing yourself. The one benefit of using a 4K camera while you're streaming or doing YouTube is that you can actually punch in and punch out if you plan on rendering at a lower resolution like 1080p. So you record at 4K, you can punch in and out at 1080p and not lose any quality loss. But if you're just using this for streaming or only using 1080p and you plan on doing a lot of gaming, shrinking your camera down to the normal face cam size, no one's gonna really be able to see the difference between 1080p and 4K at a camera size that's about this big. After you've picked what resolution you want to record or stream at, next comes clean HDMI out. So what this does is it takes the signal from the HDMI cable that's plugged into the camera, and when you plug it into your capture card, you wanna make sure that the body of the camera supports clean HDMI out. And what this means is that it doesn't show ISO, f-stop, any of the overlays that would show up on the little camera screen. It's not gonna show up on the HDMI cable when you plug it into your computer, so your viewers don't see that. Next is the continuous power. DSLRs are typically not meant to run for extended periods of time. Dummy batteries basically override that. However, not everybody supports this, so you have to make sure that the body of the camera that you're choosing supports continuous power. This is basically just an auto power off setting that you have to change within the body of the camera. Just make sure you turn auto power off after 10 minutes or however long it is to off, so it will always run. Now, lastly, this is an optional thing and something I wish I had known about before I bought my Canon, but it wasn't a deal breaker for me. I just have to use manual focus, and that is clean autofocus out. Similarly to clean HDMI out, clean autofocus basically says that when autofocus is turned on, it will always track your face, but there's no box around your face showing. So when I'm moving over here and moving over here, you would actually be seeing a box around my face if I turned autofocus on right now. The Canon 80D does not support this, but on the flip side, I don't ever have to change it. I always just leave it on manual focus anyway, and the way that I get around this on stream is I just turn it to autofocus, I sit in the spot that I need to, and then I turn it back to manual focus so that it just stays on the exact spot, because I'm not moving much on stream, so it pretty much just always stays focused right on me anyway. And as long as the camera supports clean HDMI out, when you're in manual focus, you won't see the tracking box anyway around your face. Personally, I'm a fan of manual focus because I don't like seeing cameras trying to focus in and out. Sometimes the lens won't actually be able to find your face and you'll see something else in focus, and that really annoys me. I just want the camera to sit in the same spot all the time. All right, if you guys are enjoying the video so far, please don't forget to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel. I greatly appreciate it. And don't forget that I also mentioned that I am going to be doing another video where I show you how to set up your body and your lens to get the best settings possible. And if you want, I do stream over on Twitch Wednesday through Saturday at twitch.tv/pixelperfect. So if you need any help setting anything up over there, feel free to jump in over there and talk to me. I spend quite a bit of time in just chatting, talking with the community and getting people's setups going, as well as just chatting and having a great time. Okay, I know that was a lot of information, but luckily for you, there is actually a link in the description down below where Elgato has already taken everything I have said and summarized it into one simple graphic for you. Just click the link in the description down below to take you over to the Camlink compatibility site on their website, and it'll show you by brand and by model of camera what works and what doesn't work. And it's a very clean and straightforward graphic. It's actually super helpful, and I wish they had it when I first bought it, but it's fine. Trial and error, I guess. But anyway, moving on to the fifth point, the lens choice. And this is actually the more important choice of the two between the body and the lens. The lens is what gives you the look that you're going for. Now, the lens is broken into four parts. First, you have to decide on a style of lens. There are two predominantly popular style lenses. There are more lenses than just two styles, but for this video and for the sake of streaming and content creation in general, the two main styles of lenses are wide angle and standard. The second part is focal length, and this is measured in millimeters. If you've ever seen on a lens a number with mm next to it, that is the focal length, or the zoom in which the lens sees around it. The most popular ranges for lenses right now is 14 to 30 millimeters. This is going to range from wide angle to standard lens. And right now I'm on a 30 millimeter standard Sigma lens. And I would say 30 millimeters is about as big as you can go, or as large of a zoom as you can go before it gets too close and really crops in your face. As of right now, the camera is about 4 feet away from me. Now, talking about focal length, there are two types of lenses. There's a prime lens and a zoom lens. A prime lens means it doesn't change the focal length. This lens that you're seeing me on right now is a 30 millimeter, and it can never zoom in or zoom out. It can change what it focuses on, but it can't get closer to my face unless I physically bring the camera closer to me. On the flip side of that, a zoom lens, like a standard 18 to 55 millimeter, means you can physically make the lens zoom in and zoom out. And lastly, probably the most important part of any lens you're going to be looking at is the aperture, otherwise known as the f-stop. And this is what controls your depth of field, or known as bokeh. Not only does the f-stop control how much bokeh or blurred depth of field background that you get, but it also controls how much light the lens lets in on the sensor. So right now I am on a prime 30 millimeter full frame lens at an f1.8 aperture. So remember, prime means it doesn't change the zoom, 30 millimeter is the focal length, f1.8 is the f-stop, and full frame means that it's seeing everything in the frame without being cropped. So f-stop specifically controls how much it sees within its focal field, and as the number gets lower, not only does the aperture get larger and let more light in, but it makes a much more harsh blurred background. So right now, my Sigma 30 millimeter is set to an f1.8. The desk behind me is only about a foot and a half behind me, but at an f1.8, that's why it's so blurry. If this lens were at, say, an f5.0, almost everything behind me, including myself, would all be in focus right now. But just to get that little bit of blurred background, you want anything about an f2.0 or lower. So the lower the f-stop, anything f2.0, f1.8, 1.6, 1.4, the smaller the number, the more blurred the background is going to be, and also how much more light you're going to let in on the sensor. And again, in my setup video, I'm gonna go over that so much more so you guys know how to properly set everything up. This is just so you know what lens you wanna pick. A really popular lens for DSLRs right now is actually Sigma's 16 millimeter f1.4 wide angle. So not only will you get a harsher depth of field behind me, but you'll also be able to see more in frame. Just understand that the wider the angle lens that you get, the more that you'll start to bend around the edges. Okay, so let's recap. You're going to need a dummy battery. You're going to need a micro or mini HDMI cable, but make sure you check to see if your camera comes with it first. And you're also going to need a capture card. Now, some really popular cameras that are out there are the Sony A5100, the A6000, the Canon 80D. These are not cheap cameras, and by no means am I saying it's going to be easy to buy one of these, but if you want the best quality possible, these are some of the best choices you can get for streaming. And one thing I will seriously recommend is going to the link that I put in the description down below over on Elgato's website to check the compatibility as well as what each one offers so that you know what you're looking for in your camera. And for stream, I personally use a 24 millimeter lens and an f2.8. I use the 24 millimeter because it's a little bit wider of a field of view than the 30 millimeter because it's zoomed out some. And even though f2.8 is a little bit higher of an f-stop than I'd like to use, everything behind me is far enough away that it still gets that nice blurred background that looks really natural. All right, guys, that's pretty much everything. Hopefully that wasn't too much information. Hopefully I didn't overload you too much. If you liked the video, please remember hit the thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe. Jump into the Discord if you want to ask me any questions about the body or the lens or anything like that. Also, in the free stuff category, I will have a summarized version of this in there for you that you can download so you can just kind of look at everything you need at a glance and then start making decisions for yourself. Thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed. And until next time, I'll catch you in the next video. Peace. Wraith on top, one in the door.
You slid! She just matrixed my bullet. Oh my god, dude.
No f***ing way that just happened.
That's legit Ultra Instinct music right there. Somebody clip it.